Good morning, students. I hope everyone is safe. So already we discussed about the structure of nephron and also how the urine is formed. So this structure of nephron, the urine formation, they all are occurred in the kidney. So one part only in the excretion is completed. So the next part of the excretion is ureters. These are called as the ureters. So if you see the ureters, the ureters, they arise from the kidney, from the hilus region. From the hilus region, the ureters are arising from the kidney. So the front part of the ureter, this is called as pelvis. And these ureters, they open into the urinary bladder. They open into the urinary bladder. You see the size of the ureters are nearly 30 centimeters. Approximately 30 centimeters is they have the length, and the width will be 6 to 8 millimeters. The width is up to 6 to 8 millimeters. This is about the ureters. So the urine which is formed in the nephrons, then the cell gets collected and it passes through the urinary ureters into the urinary bladder. So now we will discuss about the urinary bladder. The second one, the third one is, what is urinary bladder? So urinary bladder is a sac-like structure. It is a sac-like structure which stores urine. Urinary bladder, you see, there is a pear-shaped structure. It is a reverse pear-shaped structure. Sac, which is elastic in nature, and it stores the urine. So how much urine will be stored? It stores the urine up to 300, the capacity is 300 to 800 milliliters. It is able to store the 300 to 800 milliliters of urine will be stored in the urinary bladder. So what is its location? It is present in the abdominal cavity, besides the rectum, in the ventral side of the vertebral column. Okay, so it stores the urine and it opens outside through urethra. The urinary bladder opens outside through urethra. So now we will discuss about the fourth one. What is micturition? What is micturition? So what is this micturition? Micturition means the passing out of the passing urine outside of the body is called as micturition. So how this micturition will occur? So how this urine will come outside? So when you see this urethra, so this urethra, the size of urethra will be different in the males as well as in the females. In the females, the size of the length of the urethra will be 4 centimeters in its length. But in case of males, this size is a tube-like structure. Urethra is a tube-like structure through which the urine will be comes outside from the body. From the urinary bladder, the urine will be passes outside through this urethra. So the urethra size will be different in the females and males. In the females, it will be 4 centimeters in length, and in case of males, it will be 20 centimeters in length. So the opening will be different in the females and the males. It is a common passage for the sperm and urine. So that's what is called as the urinogenital duct in case of males. In case of males, it is called as urinogenital duct. Why? Because it passes the sperm as well as the urine. This is about the urethra. So now we will discuss about the micturition. What is micturition? The urine will be comes out from the body. The process of coming the urine outside from the body is called as micturition. So how this micturition will be takes place? So when you see this urinary bladder, here this urinary bladder near the urethra, here we have two sphincters. Here we have the two sphincters, the circular sphincters, circular muscles. They will close this valve. They close the valve. It is called as the outer sphincter and inner sphincter. When the capacity is, when the urine capacity is more, first the outer sphincter will relax. The outer sphincter will be relaxed, and the more urine will be gets collected in the urinary. urinary bladder. Understand? Then what will happen? But the inner sphincter, it will be the constriction, relaxation will be controlled by the brain. Controlled by the brain. When this means urinary bladder is filled by 400 to 500 ml of urine, then automatically what will happen? It means you get the urge, the reflex actions will start, and automatically the urge of urination will start. So it is a voluntary action in case of adults, and in case of small children and junior children, it is a involuntary action, and slowly they learn. Okay, ma? So the capacity, the maximum capacity will be 600 to 700 ml. So when the 600, when the urinary bladder is filled by 600 to 700 ml, automatically what will happen? They will get the pain, a type of pain to pass the urine out. So the urge of getting the pain. So when it is a voluntary action, so that's the what will happen. So automatically they will take the permission and go and pass the urine. So the passing of urine outside from the body is called as the micturition. So now we'll discuss about what is the composition of the urine. So when you see the composition of the urine will be amber color, means like pale yellow in color. The color of the urine will be amber color. So amber color means pale yellow in color. So if you see the composition of the urine contains 96% of water. How much water this contains? 96% of water and 2.5% of organic substances. So what are the organic substances? Urea, uric acid, creatinine, creatinine. So they are called as the organic substances. So it contains, you see they have given here 2.5 organic substances, urea, uric acid, creatinine, creatine, water, soluble vitamins, hormones and oxalates. These are the organic substances of the urine. And inorganic substances. So what are the inorganic substances? The ions of sodium, chlorine, potassium, phosphate, sulfate, magnesium, calcium, iodine. So these are the inorganic salts. So organic salts, if you see this 100% of urine, 100% of urine. So out of this 100%, 96% will be water. 96% will be water and 2.5% will be organic substances. Organic substances. So what are these organic substances? They are urea, uric acid, creatine, creatinine and oxalates, vitamins and hormones. These are the organic substances of the urine. Then when you come to the inorganic substances, it contains 1.5% of inorganic substances. So these inorganic substances are what? The ions of sodium, chlorine, potassium, magnesium, iodine, and they have given phosphate, sulfate, magnesium. So these are the inorganic substances of the urine. And it contains the pH value is 6. The pH value of urine is 6. So actually the urine will be acidic in nature. So when it stores in the urinary bladder, it converted into alkaline, turned into alkaline. So the forming, the composition will be varies. The composition of the urine will be varies from time to time and depends upon our diet. So if you take more proteinaceous food, then the amino acid proteins will be deaminated. That's why more nitrogenous waste will be produced. So at that time, this urea percent will be more in the food, so in the urine. So in the same way, if you take more intake of sugars, so what automatically the sugar content will be more in the urine. Especially you might have seen the diabetic patients, this sugar will be passed out through this urine. So that's why it means the formation or composition of the urine will be various depends upon our diet. So this is about yours today's lessons. Already we discussed about the structure of the kidneys and the total excretory system. Kidneys the next class we'll discuss about the what is dialysis. So what will happen when both the kidneys gets failed? So at that time, what is the process, the artificial process which purifies the blood? That one we'll discuss in the next lesson. In the next class. Thank you.